An introduction to emerging patterns. Hello, and welcome to this short overview of AutoChartist's emerging patterns. We have briefly touched on the concept of emerging patterns in both the videos on chart patterns and Fibonacci patterns. The purpose of this video is to explore this special class of pattern a little bit further, and to look at the different ways in which they can benefit you as a trader. I will cover emerging patterns for both chart patterns and Fibonacci patterns, and I will also bring in key level approaches at the end of the discussion. As always, let's start with emerging chart patterns. Due to the nature of how chart patterns are identified, we were able to adapt the AutoChartist recognition engine to find chart patterns as soon as they had touched the last point on either the support or resistance line necessary to complete its shape. At this point, we know the shape of the pattern, but we don't know whether the price would continue to break through support or resistance. This is the fundamental difference between an emerging and complete pattern. When an emerging pattern is identified, price still trades between the support and resistance lines. If a pattern has completed, then it means the price has broken through the support or resistance line. Does it matter in which direction it breaks out? Yes, most definitely. The breakout has to happen away from the last turning point. There are some other characteristics that will also tell you what the direction of the breakout should be, and those are the direction of the initial trend, together with whether the pattern is a reversal or continuation. Remember our discussion in the video on chart patterns. Continuation patterns break out in the same direction as initial trend, while reversal patterns break out in the opposite direction to the initial trend. The easiest way for you to know in which direction the pattern is expected to break out is to see where the direction arrow is pointing. On the graph, there are a number of visual cues that tells you whether you are looking at an emerging or a completed pattern. The most obvious feature of an emerging pattern is the two yellow dotted lines that extend the support and resistance lines. Their purpose is to give you a visual of the continuation of the expected trading range. The opportunities that many swing traders are looking for are situations where price becomes range-bound and it continues to bounce between support and resistance. They go long on the upward bounce and short on the downward, for as long as it stays within the range. The most obvious feature of a completed pattern is the gray forecast region with the colored target level. If you see this construction next to a chart pattern, then you will know that it has completed by breaking through either the support or resistance level, and it has an overall average chance of 70% that it will reach the target level. In this grid below, you can distinguish between emerging and completed patterns in the type column, as well as the direction arrow. Completed patterns have colored arrows, while the arrows of emerging patterns are grayed out. Let's take a look at some trade opportunities on emerging patterns. As we've said before, the most common way in which people trade emerging patterns is by trading the upswings and downswings within the range between support and resistance. For this reason, we would want to look for emerging patterns where the range is sufficiently wide, and where it doesn't become too narrow too soon. So it is trending patterns, like channels, that we find ideal, and not so much the non-trending patterns like triangles. Now, we simply try to find patterns that have a nicely defined range that have just bumped off the support or resistance line, that has a reasonable distance to cover until it reaches the opposite boundary. So when an emerging pattern either crosses the correct boundary and completes, or whether the price turns around and goes the opposite direction before it does, the pattern will be removed from this list, because in both those cases, it will no longer be tradable. Let's take a look now at emerging Fibonacci patterns. There are three main groups of Fibonacci patterns. We have 3-point patterns like retracements and extensions, 4-point patterns, the ABCDs, and 5-point patterns, like Gartley's, butterflies, and 3-drives. As we have mentioned in the video on Fibonacci patterns, all 3-point retracements are emerging 4-point ABCDs, and many 4-point ABCDs are also emerging 5-point Gartley's or butterflies. This is because the patterns with more points contain or are made up from patterns with fewer points. The way to recognize that you are looking at an emerging Fibonacci pattern is also the color of the direction arrow. If it is grayed out, the pattern is emerging, but a more obvious feature is the pink dot on emerging patterns. Unlike with chart patterns where emerging patterns can be straightforward opportunities to trade, with Fibonacci patterns, they really are just an early warning signal. Because for the opportunity to realize, two things still need to happen. First, the price has to rise to the level of the pink dot. Time is not that important. It can reach the level before or after the dot, as long as it is on that level. Then the second thing that needs to happen is that price should encounter support or resistance at the level of the dot, depending on whether it is a bullish or bearish pattern. So, Only if the price reaches this level and turns around at this level, then the expectation is that there will be support or resistance at the Fibonacci levels that follow. Because of the many requirements for a Fibonacci emerging pattern to complete, there are many of them that never do. And as a trader, the ones that will be of more interest to you would be the higher order ones, the 5-point Gartleys and butterflies, because they are more valuable patterns. And the way they fit with the Fibonacci theory by meeting a considerable number of requirements, you are increasing your odds for trading in the right direction. I would not spend much of my time waiting for retracements to turn into ABCDs. But if you have a pattern that forms over a longer period, because remember that market psychology takes time, it matures like red wine, then you have a chance at having the theory pay out for you. At the beginning, I also mentioned that I want to bring in the key level approaches to the discussion. The reason for this is that there is somewhat of an analogy between approaches and emerging patterns. With all the other emerging patterns we have looked at, price is always approaching some target level. Whether it reaches it or not remains to be seen. We have decided not to call key level approaches emerging patterns, because they are fully fledged trading opportunities on their own. There are no additional requirements that are needed for them to be tradable. Like with chart patterns that should ideally be trending or Fibonacci that has to reach support or resistance. These key level patterns can be traded straight away and they are highly successful. With some of the best performing statistics, some 80% of approaches reaching support or resistance. So, take your time in figuring out the characteristics of the various types of emerging patterns. And remember that there is no sure, quick way to land yourself a lot of money. You have to use that clever brain of yours, listen to what other people who have more experience have to say, and do your homework. That way, you increase your chances of success. And you can use AutoChartist to save you a lot of time in the process. Give us a